trains, obviously, and all of those refurbished trains and any of the trains that are brought in from around the country. We've done a significant amount with other colleagues in the Arriva group. I would say it's not as fast as I would like on the whole integration piece, bringing bus and rail together and demand responsive. But we have done quite a lot of that, particularly in the northeast, where we are the biggest transport operator, both with their bus and their various rail franchising operations. And again, we're looking to test that out elsewhere. It's a good site for that to be done with the buses. And we've also invested in quite a lot of customer experience, so increasing the number of people employed, both in our customer experience centre in Shepherd. So there's a lot of good stuff going on. I'm happy to answer any questions from Sharon, with Sharon in a few minutes. I guess the couple of other things I want to touch on. One is the current dispute that we have with the RMT union, which has now been running for 9 months. And we've had 11 days, and next week we have 3 days. So Monday, Wednesday, Friday is a further dispute. And this is about role of conductor, future role of conductor, and I know that you're aware of this issue, but locally they are different, so the Merseyrail system is different to the normal system. And we are, as part of our franchise, looking to improve the level of customer service on board and making sure that the operation that we introduce is fully safe. We can only run railway systems in this country if they're fully compliant safety case, but what we would like is the driver to be responsible. Doors, giving the conductor more opportunities to spend time in the train, giving service information, selling tickets, and checking tickets. We're part of what is clearly a nationally coordinated industrial dispute now, a lot of disputes going on at a range of places across the country. And we are continuing to engage as proactively as we can with our staff. So we are not engaging in tactics deployed by other franchises. We do have no dispute with ourselves. There is a dispute between the union and the contractors we have to offer on behalf of the government. And despite rumours to the contrary, we have limited flexibility in changing that contract. So we are not the Scottish government or the Welsh government. We're a contractor to the union. And it is very difficult at the moment to try to make progress on discussions about the future role of the conductor because we can't give that cast iron guarantee that there will be a safety critical guard on every train, because that's not the case. So we're stuck in a little bit of a long jam, but again, I'm happy as usual to answer the question. What we have done is we significantly increased the number of trains that operate every strike day. That's gone from 40% to 53%, and that will next week will increase again slightly. So we are now getting more people volunteering for our management cohort to operate trains. So we will continue to offer better customer offer to people on strike days, and in essence, between 7 and 7 is broadly the normal service. So the impact on customers is reducing every time there's a dispute. And we have a number of plans in place that each time a dispute is announced, we'll try to mitigate and reduce the impact on our travel. I think next week will be the first test because 3 days is quite a significant impact, and I think that's probably the first real work, residential work we have. Secondly, an issue that I know is dear to many of your hearts is the Southport to Manchester line. So again, I'm just going to quickly recap on a little bit of the history. In essence, there was a timetable, an ITT specified by the franchise. The Arriva bid in line with that. And we are trying to make the most of the current infrastructure capacity. We're also trying to plan on the additional capacity that Network Rail will deliver as part of their Great Rail North project. Also, until 2019-2020, we are limited on the volume of trains we have. So we only have so many, our influx of new trains really starts in 2019. So they're the sort of limiting factors. In the May timetable, we have bid to Network Rail, but complicated, but we bid and said this is what we would like to operate. I think we reviewed the bid that Arriva originally put in place. Quite a lot of feedback from local stakeholders. We did a survey of customer use, particularly on the given you a flavour of what we're going to deliver. It is based on a growing franchise. I think the start really, one of the things that Craig and Sharon are really keen on is making sure that we play our part as part of the major events that you have here. I know how much effort goes into it, and I remember before the heavy rails are part of the bargain, sometimes let us down on some of the big events, but I think building on the work that Liz and others have done over the years is making sure that we're supporting you. So hopefully that's given you a bit of a flavour. There's an awful lot going on. I think it's fair to say it's been not a slow start, but